Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install CodeBlocks in a Windows 11 operating system. So let's begin. Now before installing CodeBlocks, let us first understand what this software basically does. So let's say you want to code in C or C++, then CodeBlocks is a very good IDE. So this will come with a MinGW compiler, which will help you to compile your code, and it will, you know, generate an executable file, which will, you know, automatically going to execute right at your IDE. So I'm going to show you all of that in this video. Right, so let's begin. Now, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser to download our installer file, and in that address bar, basically you need to just simply type CodeBlocks download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this codeblocks.org is basically our first search result. So just need to simply click on this downloads CodeBlocks, and this will now going to redirect you to this official site of CodeBlocks. I'll be also putting this link in the description, so you don't need to worry about the link and all. And here you'll be getting this download the binary files. So just need to simply click on that, and this will now going to redirect you to this binary release page. And here, if you just simply scroll down a bit under this Microsoft Windows, you can see that there are so many options. From here, you need to download this fourth one. See, CodeBlocks 20.03 MinGW setup. So we are going to install this MinGW one, right? So fourth one, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And here you need to just simply click on this sourceforge.net. And you can see that it has, you know, right, redirect you to the sourceforce.net, and our download is going to be start now, and it has rightly started over here. So since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that our CodeBlocks 20.03 MinGW setup has been rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And this is, you know, going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you can see that our CodeBlocks installation wizard has been directly opened over here. So let us first minimize our download directory. And then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our license agreement. So if you want to read, you can always read that. And just simply click on I agree. So these are the files that they're going to be installed. So keep this as a default. Just one thing need to be checked is that you need to have 531.5 MB of free space in your C drive. Right, so do check that, and then just simply click on next. This is going to be our installation destination. Keep this as default. If you want to change, you can do that, but I'll be recommending you to keep this as default. Then just simply click on install. And you can see that our installation of CodeBlocks has been rightly started over here. So this will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our CodeBlocks. Yeah. So welcome back. Now you can clearly see that our CodeBlocks has been almost installed and is currently asking, do you want to run CodeBlocks now? So I would like to run our CodeBlocks now. So just simply click on yes. And it will, you know, going to finish our CodeBlocks installation setup, and it is, you know, going to be launched. So our CodeBlocks 20.03 will be launching in a while. And now it's asking that that GNU GCC compiler is properly detected. So current default compiler is GNU GCC compiler. Right, so it is always recommended to use this GNU GCC compiler. So keep this as default, then just simply click on OK. And then just simply click on next, and then finish. And you can see that our CodeBlocks IDE has been rightly opened over here. And now it's asking whether you'd like to, you know, make CodeBlocks as a default C++ source file. So CodeBlocks is a very good IDE, so it is always recommended to make CodeBlocks as a default C++ source files. So if you want to make it as a default, you need to just simply click on yes, and you can do that, right? And then just simply click on OK, and it will, you know, going to make this CodeBlocks as a default C++, right? And now I'm going to show you how to run a simple Hello World C program, and then I'll also show you how to execute it and how to run them, right? So stay tuned. So for that, all you need to do is you need to first simply click on this icon called new file. You can also open it from file, then new, then empty file. Those are all basically same, right? And here you need to then first simply go to file again, then save as. And here under this document, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to name it as a C_progs, right? So we are going to write as a C program. Just simply go inside that folder and then let's give the file name as a prog.c. Why C? Because we are going to write this program in C program, right? If you want to write it as a C++ program, then you need to write it as a .cpp extension, right? So do remember that. For C++, you need to save it as a .cpp. For C, you need to save it as a .c, right? And then just simply click on save. And you can see that our prog.c has been rightly saved over here. So here, we are going to write a simple hello world program. So basically hash include stdio.h, then int main. And we're going to, you know, simply first go inside that main method, and then since we are returning int, we need to return something, right? So we are returning 0, and here we are going to simply print hello world, right? So hello world, right? And just simply end with a semicolon. And now if you just simply click on this run button, it will, you know, going to ask you whether you'd like to save it and you'd like to build it now. So just simply click on yes, and it will, you know, going to save it, and you can see that our hello world has been rightly shown in our console, right? So in this way, you can easily install CodeBlocks IDE in a Windows 11 operating system. This will help you to make your entire coding experience in C and C++ a very great, I would say. Right, so you don't need to compile it, you don't need to build it again and again, right? All executing, creating executable files and running that file, say they going to do it all in this IDE itself on a single click of a button, right? So these are the all features that you'll be getting in CodeBlocks, right? So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching.